This is the World of Sports Network presentation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Welcome to another World of Sports Network presentation. So today we're going to do the mock draft. So we're going to start with pick 32 through pick 23. Yes, 23 because of Jordan. You know, the best number in the history of numbers. So y'all remember, pick 32 through pick 23, mock draft. Now let's roll the tape. So with the 32nd pick of the 2020 draft, the Kansas City Chiefs will choose running back from the University of Georgia, DeAndre Swift. Now it's very simple. The Chiefs are the Super Bowl champions. I mean, they basically got everything they need. But this team is led by Patrick Mahomes, and it's an offensive team. So the only glaring weakness you can see, it could be really the glaring weakness is a cornerback. But at the 32nd pick, the tough flight corners will be gone at that time. So what's going to be left is the tough flight running back. So it's going to be the time for the running back. So Swift fit exactly the Andy Reid type of offense, man. He could catch the ball out the backfield. He could run in between the tackle. He's very effective as far as his screenplay. So he's going to be another versatile weapon for the already Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs offense. So look for the Chiefs to add DeAndre Swift from the University of Georgia as their number 32nd pick. With the 31st pick, the San Francisco 49ers will go with wide receiver from TCU, Jalen Reagor. The reason why this pick is Mike Shanahan and Kyle Shanahan, they need an explosive receiver. Obviously, Emmanuel Sanders left them last year, and what they were lacking is somebody that could take the top off, somebody that could scare the defense or cornerbacks, somebody that could back them out a little bit to open up the run game, open up more of the intermediate passing game. So I think Jalen Reagor from TCU will fit that bill perfectly. Because of the 32nd pick, I was debating between a corner at this position. But like I mentioned, I don't think the top tier cornerback they're looking for will also be available at the 31st pick. So I see the 49ers going with Jalen Reagor to help the offense be a little bit more explosive passing wise. So now let's move on to the 30th pick of my mock draft. And the Green Bay Packers, I have them going with wide receiver Brandon Ayuk from Arizona State. I think this is just fitting. And Aaron Rodgers need help. Davante Adams is the only receivers. We saw last year with all the young receivers that went through, nobody really stuck. So they need a playmaker. They need somebody opposite Davante Adams to help Aaron Rodgers. Obviously, Aaron Rodgers is getting up there as far as age. So they got to put it all in with the offense. The emergence of Aaron Jones, that obviously helped the Packers. But they need someone opposite Davante Adams. And Brandon Ayuk from Arizona State, explosive talent. I mean, when you put the ball in his hand, he's one of the best receivers after the catch, run after the catch, and he gets yacked, man. I think he's one of those guys, Aaron Rodgers could throw a slant, and he take it to the house for 7 yards. So look for Brandon Ayuk to fit perfectly in Green Bay. So now with the 29th pick, the Tennessee Titans. Yes, the surprising team of last year, per se. The Tennessee Titans, they're a physical team, man. So we already know their identity and their culture. So one thing is, I got the Tennessee Titans select Jeff Gladney, cornerback from TCU. Talking about a prototype cornerback that fit that culture. This is a tough, hard-nosed kid, man. A pesky kid that would fit exactly what Mike Vrabel and company are doing in Tennessee, man. So he just fits that feisty. He fits Tennessee. I think it's a no-brainer. The Titans with Jeff Gladney from TCU. One of the toughest cornerbacks in this draft. So with the 28th pick, the Baltimore Ravens on the clock. And they were going with linebacker from Oklahoma, Kenneth Murray. I mean, this is a no-brainer. This is a no-nonsense kid. His leadership quality, everything about him, make him look like a Baltimore Ravens to lead the Ravens in the middle. We all know the Ravens' culture and history as far as having a superior elite talent in the middle. And look for Kenneth Murray to come in and bring instant leadership and joining that instant culture. And he will be a dominant linebacker in the AFC North for years to come. So Kenneth Murray with the 28th pick for the Baltimore Ravens. Now let's move to the Seattle Seahawks with the 27th pick of the draft. With the way the draft is going to fall, it's going to fall perfectly for the Seahawks. They were one of the lowest teams as far as defensively of getting sacks last year. So this is going to be a perfect time to get one of the best day one ready sack specialists in the draft. That is Penn State defensive end Yuturo Gross Mateos. I think he's going to fit perfectly. We're talking about a professional pass rusher. He's already established his hand movement. All he does is get pressure, and the Seahawks, especially Clowney, don't come back, or he don't end up signing Everson Griffin to help out. But I see Yuturo Mateos Gross from Penn State as the 27th selection in Seattle. Pete Carroll loved those long arms defensive end, and he fits the prototype for the Seahawks. Now let's move on to pick 26 for the Miami Dolphins, the third of three first round pick. With this pick, the Miami Dolphins were going with the running back, Jonathan Taylor from Minnesota. I don't even want to overanalyze this kid. This kid, all he does is produce. His production is out of this world. You put in the tape in Wisconsin for the last 3 years, you will see Jonathan Taylor just running, catching, running through, running around, just basically dominating the Big Ten. And he will fit the identity, what they're trying to establish in Miami. He's a Wisconsin kid. He's a great locker room kid. He's a great off the field kid. He's a great character kid. And he fits exactly what the Dolphins are trying to establish. So Jonathan Taylor, Miami Dolphins with the 26th pick in the draft. Now we move on to the 25th pick in the draft, which will be for the Minnesota Vikings, man. Mike Zimmer, defensive guy. Love this pick. I've been waiting for this pick for a while. With obviously the loss of Xavier Rhodes, the secondary is in a mesh. It seemed like the Vikings are in a slowly rebuilding period defensively. So with that said, I'm sticking with the corners. I think Minnesota Vikings with Mike Zimmer, who's a great secondary coach, will go to Utah and get one of my favorite corner in the draft, Jalen Johnson from Utah. He's a total one of the most complete corner in this draft. This guy's a total one-on-one corner guy. He could play off man, on man, great ball skills. I mean, this dude is a super over athlete, twitch muscles, I think, and he's have high, exceptional high football IQ. Jalen Johnson is a Mike Zimmer guy, tough guy, and I expect the Minnesota Vikings to slot Jalen Johnson in from day one, and he will be a big time player. Minnesota Vikings select cornerback Jalen Johnson from the Utah Utes. Now let's move to pick 24 with the New Orleans Saints. Yes, we'll continue the run of cornerback. The New Orleans Saints, you look at their roster, man, they're one of the most complete roster in all of football. So with that said, it seems like every year the Saints struggle in the secondary and the back end. They feel like they try everyone from Eli Apple to Janoris Jenkins to that, anyone to try to help Marshawn Lattimore. And I think now with New Orleans, they only got to go far. Stay locally. I see Tristan Fulton from LSU staying home in Louisiana will be lined up next to Marshawn Lattimore. I say the New Orleans Saints are going to pick cornerback from LSU, Tristan Fulton. And I think that's what's going to help the defense. Marshawn Lattimore needs help. The defense seems like they're always the reason why it seems like the Saints come up short. So I think having a guy like Fulton, who's one of the best corners out there, very productive, had many, many reps in that position, played at a high level in the SEC. I mean, it's hard to complete ball against this guy, man. So I think he's going to just bring that type of feistiness they need over there opposite Marshawn Lattimore. So I see New Orleans finally having a corner to opposite Lattimore to have one of the top two duos, young duos moving forward. Tristan Fulton from Louisiana State University, a.k.a. DBU, right? So now, let's move for the last pick of this first session is the New England Patriots at pick 23. Pick 23. I think the New England Patriots, they're rebuilding. Obviously, we see what's going on with Tom Brady. And so they're doing a whole change. So with that, New England always like versatility. I see Iowa defensive end AJ Epenesa. This will look like a New England type guy, man. The versatility of playing inside, outside, high football IQ. I think he's a piece that Bill Belichick loves to play with as a defensive specialist. AJ Epenesa from Iowa, I think will fit perfectly that in as a building block interior, an interior line for the New England Patriots. So yes, Iowa, you could never go wrong with a Kirk Ferentz guy. You never go wrong with an Iowa man. You could never go wrong with a Big Ten guy. You know, Big Ten guys just know how to play football. So with that said, y'all, just a review from pick 32 to 23. All right, 32, the Chiefs went with DeAndre Swift, running back from Georgia. 31st pick, the 49ers went with wide receiver Jalen Reagor. The 30th pick, the Packers went with Brandon Ayuk, wide receiver for Arizona State. The Titans will go with Jeff Gladney, cornerback from TCU. With the 28th pick, the Ravens will go with Oklahoma linebacker Kenneth Murray. With the 27th pick, the Seahawks are going with Penn State defensive end Yetur Mateo Gross. With the 26th pick, the Dolphins are going with running back from Wisconsin, Jonathan Taylor. With the 25th pick, the Minnesota Vikings are going with cornerback from Utah, Jalen Johnson. With the 24th pick, the New Orleans Saints are going with cornerback Tristan Fulton from Louisiana State. And then with the 23rd pick, the New England Patriots are going with defensive lineman AJ Epenesa from Iowa. Now, y'all remember, this is just my 32 to 23rd pick. So, y'all stay tuned. Come back tomorrow where I will have my pick 21 all the way up to 11. Y'all remember, man, like this, love this, share this, and I am out.